What is the answer of last question? Can anyone solve? What is the answer of your last question?
5.62.
28 is not the right answer. So just observe here.
0.398.
So just you all see. I think it's a very easy question, but no one saying the right answer. So this is your gari. Here also this is your gari. It means this is your vehicle. This vehicle traveling with 30 km. Also, this vehicle is traveling with 30 km per hour. This vehicle traveling up. This vehicle traveling down. So basically, you already know, because during calculation of SSD, I say to you all that during down gradient, SSD required is much, but during up gradient, SSD required is less. So in question, they give your when your driver is traveling on an up gradient with a speed of 80 km per hour, they require 9 meters less SSD than your down gradient. Coefficient of friction they give. Coefficient of friction they give F is equal to 0.4. So just they ask from you that calculate the value of slope or calculate the value of gradient. What is the S value? That means what is this theta? This is theta, that means this is our S, this is our slope, this is our gradient. What is this theta? So no much rocket science is involved in this question. So just solve this question as your lag distance for up plus braking distance for up vehicle, braking distance for up vehicle is equal to lag distance for your down vehicle plus braking distance for your down vehicle. But in question they give this up gradient required 9 meters less than this down. So basically we have to add to equate these both equation. We must add here 9 because here we get 100, here we get only 91. If suppose here we get a stopping side distance, because you already know a stopping side distance is the summation of your lag distance plus braking distance. So if this value comes out to be 100 meter, then only this value comes out to be 91 meter. So in question they give 9 meter less. So for equating both equation, we add here 9. Also in this equation, you multiply here 9. If someone do not add 9 here, you just multiply here 9 and equate both the equation. So basically I say this thing, that here your lag distance for up vehicle and lag distance for your down vehicle is same, because here also you multiply 80 into 2.5, and also here you get 80 into 2.5. So here you get 80 into 2.5. And also here you get 80 into 2.5. Here you get 80 into 2.5. Getting or not getting? You getting? Yes, yeah, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So basically, we cancel this term. We cancel this term. Just use only this equation. Only we use this equation, which is here. Lag breaking distance for a backheel, because lag distance is cancelled, plus 9 is equal to lag distance, sorry, breaking distance for down backheel. So we know the relationship, or we know the equation. Here we use b square by 254 f plus, here we use plus sign because this is the case of up gradient, so plus s plus 9 is equal to v square by 254 f minus s. Then what we get here, just here we get, here v is 80, here v is your 80 kilometer per hour, 80. Also here v is your 80. So just put the value of velocity here or speed here, 80 square by 254 f value is also given here. F value is 0.4, so put the value of f as 0.4 plus s is equal to plus 9. Here we get plus 9 is equal to 80 square by 254. Here we use 0.4 minus s. So just simplify this equation. What is the answer coming out? What is the s value?
Sir, s ka value 5.62, aur ek dusra value aaya.
What is the other value? What is the 0.02? So just, yes, see, sir. Here
0.32.
So just here you get, I think, 6400. Here you get 8 square, 64, and into 80 into 80, you get 6400. You get here 6400. When you divide 6400 with 254 divide by 254, you get here 25.19, and on denominator you get 0.4 plus s. Basically you get 0.4 plus s. And here So here you get, I think 25 point, here you get 9, and here also you get 9. What is the right answer? Because no anyone give me the right answer. What is the value of S or gradient? Just solve this equation. 25.19 by 0.4 plus S plus 9 is equal to 25.19 by 0.4 minus S. Solve this equation. What is the answer coming out? What is the answer? Amit? Amrit?
Sir, calculate.
Okay, calculate. Because I simplify all the things from my sides. So what is the answer coming out? What is the answer? No one is saying anything. The value of S is, the value of S is 0.0284. So basically this S is your 2.84%. So your gradient, the value of gradient is 2.84%. I think Rohit, who is saying 28.4, someone is saying 28.4. I think Rajiv Ranjan is saying, Rajiv Ranjan is saying, sir, 28.4. Yes, Rajiv, you are saying, sir, 28.4?
No, sir, I'm not. Ranjan
Kumar.
Okay, Ranjan is saying, sir, 28.4. So this is the answer. Your gradient required is 2.84. Because you already see these things, during camber discussion, I give you the maximum camber provided on your pavement surface is, I think, 4%. Or with solder, we provide maximum 5%. So on road, if we restrict our camber, we restrict our solder as 4 to 5%, how you drive your vehicle with 28% gradient? 28% gradient, can you imagine? So basically our gradient value each lies up to maximum 7 to 8%. So if in your answer, if you get gradient more than 7 to 8%, then you check your answer, because maximum value of gradient in any answer each lies up to 7 to 8%. So in previous question, I discussed how we committed mistake during calculation of SSD. If your coefficient of friction value is given much greater than 0.3 to 0.4%. Here I already discussed that in during, if you have calci, then you solve this equation. But during calculation, if you get your gradient as 0.0284, so someone is saying, sir, 28.4. So when he is saying 28.4, then in option they already give the gradient value as 0.284%, then they give 2.84%, then they give 28.4%, because in option they give option A this, option B 2.8, option C 28.4. so in option they tick C option. So he or she committed mistake, because B is the right answer. So C what is the given in the question and how we tackle with that question. So I think, is it clear to everyone? Where we committed mistake in this type of question, because in this type of question for calculation of SST, what they give? They give us design speed, they give us reaction time, they give us coefficient of friction. So basically, when they give design speed, we just apply our lag distance formula, which is design speed into reaction time. Given design speed is multiplied with reaction time. So during lag distance calculation, you take a serious notes on this point. That is, you must multiply with 0.278 with your design speed, because if you do not multiply with 0.278 into VD into TR, then your VD into TR, that means design speed into reaction time, will be in your meter per second, because during derivation of your lag distance, I focus on this point also, that in every question, they give speed in kilometer per hour. So before calculation of lag distance, you must multiply with 0.278. So during examination, various students committed mistake here, that they do not multiply with 0.278. They simply multiply with VD into TR. They put 90 into 2.4. So they solve their answers. And in option, the examiner also fit up option by using only VD into TR. So these are the mistakes which will be involved in your examination. So please take a serious notes on these points. So basically, in question, they give lag distance, multiply with 0.278 into VD into TR. Then you come at your lag distance calculation. Use your formula V square by 254F. V is given, that means your design speed is given, your coefficient of friction is given. If your coefficient of friction is more than 0.35, less than 0.35, no problem. If your coefficient of friction is more than 0.4, then you must check in your question that at any place your braking efficiency of vehicle is given or not. Generally, if your coefficient of friction is much greater than 0.4, then in question, they give your braking efficiency. So just multiply with coefficient of friction with braking efficiency, you get modified coefficient of friction. So just put the coefficient of friction value into your braking distance formula. So just add your lag distance plus braking distance, you get your stopping side distance. Next, when you travel on your up gradient, you just add coefficient of friction with your up gradient or your slope. So F plus S is used as denominator. If you move on your down gradient, then just subtract with coefficient of frictions. So if anything is here, you observe here V square by 254 F minus S. So here we subtract coefficient of we subtract our gradient with coefficient of frictions. So here our upper value is just here, upper value is same. Here also upper value is same. So then here we get in denominator, here we get more value, here we get less value. So when less value is divided with more value, then here more result will come, here less result will come. So basically on down gradient, we required more stopping side distance, and during our up gradient, we required less stopping side distance. So these are the key points or key notes which will be kept you all in your mind during solving the problems of your SST. So it is all about your SST. So is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I think you all solve or some problem. So next question is, calculate the stopping side distance. So basically, this is next question. Question is saying, calculate the safe stopping side distance. So they say safe stopping side distance. So it is another name of our stopping side distance, because in question, if they give absolute minimum side distance, find out absolute minimum side distance. If they give safe stopping side distance. If they give stopping side distance, all nomenclature are same. All nomenclature are for our stopping side distance. So in question they give calculate the safe stopping side distance for design speed of 50 kilometer per hour. Here our design speed is, that means V is 50 kilometer per hour. Here V is 50 kilometer per hour. So in question they give calculate the safe stopping side distance for a design speed of 50 kilometer per hour for option A, two way traffic on a two lane road. Traffic is two way. They give two way traffic on a two lane road. Two way traffic on a two lane road. Two way traffic on a two lane road. On a two lane road. Next is your, two-way traffic on a single lane road. Next they give two-way traffic. Traffic is two-way. Two-way traffic on a single lane road. SINGLE is single lane road. Here they give us the coefficient of friction value as F is equal to 0.37. Basically, the coefficient of friction value lies in the range of 0.35 to 0.4. So they give coefficient of friction value as 0.37 and reaction time is 2.5 seconds. So solve this question. Question is saying, calculate the safe stopping side distance for a design speed of 50 kilometer per hour if coefficient of friction is 0.37 and if reaction time is 2.5 meter. In two condition, सब कुछ खत्म हो गया. So you all solve this problem. Your design speed is 50 kilometer per hour.
61.35 आया पाला का और दूसरा का आया उसी का into two.
Okay. Good. Your answer is right. So I think V is 50 kilometer per hour. Your friction value is 0.37. Your reaction time is 2.5 second. Then in question they give if your traffic is two-way traffic on a two-lane road. So basically, if your lane is two, here this is one lane. Here in this lane traffic is moving. Also in this lane traffic is moving. So first condition is if two-way traffic is allowed on a two-lane road. So just you get what is the answer?
61.35.
Okay, you get 61.35. So this is right answer. So answer is 61.4. So option A is, answer is 61.4 meter. So basically he just use the basic formula, which is lag distance plus braking distance. So SSD is equal to 0.278 into VD into TR plus V square by 254F. So So all the values are given. You just multiply 50 into 2.5. You get what? What you get?
61.35.
He multiplied 0.278. Multiplied 0.278 into 50 into 2.5 for lag distance calculation into 50 into 2. So 50 into 2.5. So this is lag distance. So this is basically the lag distance. Then the braking distance is huge plus V square by 254. V square is given 50 square by 254. F value is also given 0.37. So he gets 61.4. 61.4 meter. So this is the right answer. But in second condition, they give our lane is only one lane, matlab single lane. That means this is the lane. This is our one lane. And in this one lane, two-way traffic is permitted. That means also from this direction, one vehicle is coming. So when in for this condition, I give you a note point that if your width is restricted or if your single lane is given, then your SST is equal to SST1 plus SST2. But here, no other vehicle or no opposite vehicle speed is given. So just be double this value. So this is 61.4 meter. Just double this value. So I think you get 122.8. So this is the answer for our second condition. So basically, second answer is 122.8 meter. So this is the right answer. So is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
So also solve one problem. Another problem you all solve. Question is saying, just listen the question carefully, because if network is or if net issue is occur, then all the question I write on white pad or whiteboard will be deleted. So just listen the question. Calculate the stopping side distance on a highway at a descending gradient of 2%. So here descending gradient is given. Descending gradient is 2%. So here our descending gradient is given, which is 2%. So question is saying, calculate the stopping side distance on a highway at a descending gradient of 2% for a design speed of 80 km per hour. Here V is given as 80 km per hour. So here V is given as 80 km per hour. 80 km per hour. What are the things given in question? In question, they give calculate the stopping side distance. That means calculate SST in which condition? In the condition when your vehicle is moving on a descending gradient or a down gradient, the value of gradient is 2%. Also, design speed is 80 km per hour. And also in question, they give the value of friction is 0.35, and I think TR is known to you all. So just find the value of SSD. F is equal to 0.35 and TR is known to you all. So just find the value of SSD. So these are the type of question they asked in examination. So if you see here, I think all question will be solved from your sides. So these are the very basic questions they asked in your examinations. So also this question is asked in your GATE examination, GATE 2012. So calculate the answer. Calculate your SST. What is the SST? What is the SST? If in question they give calculate the stopping side distance on a highway at a descending gradient of 2% for a design speed of 80 km per hour, if coefficient of friction is 0.35, 131.9. Okay. Any other answer? 131.9. I think Ranjan is saying 131.9. Any other answer?
131.95.
Okay, you get the answer 131.95. So I think you all reach up to this answer. So 131.8 to 131.95. So this is the right answer. So the right answer is 132 meter. So in option they give 132 meter. So I think you all reach to your accurate answer, because 131.85, 131.95, 131.95 will be equal to, I think, 132. So this is the right answer. What you all do, you just apply the basic equation of SST, which is 0.278 into V into dr plus V square by 254 F. Here you use minus sign, because here our gradient is down gradient. So basically you use here F minus S. Here a value is 0.35, 2% is written at 0.002. Here just you subtract with 0.35 with 0.002. Okay, so you get here 0.33 you get. So just V square by 254 F minus S. If here in question they give up gradient, then you just add with F value. So just you add here 0.35 plus 0.002, you get 0.37. So here our braking distance will get changed. So these are the basic questions which is asked in your examinations. So I think this is the last question from my side, because these are the various type of question asked in your examination. So in recent time, what get changed in this type of questions? So just listen carefully here. Note. So during this recent time, what get modified in this question? In recent time, in GATE examination, they give you the value of SST. They give you the value of this speed. They give you the value of reaction time and ask you to find the value of coefficient of friction. So this is the modification done by GATE in recent time. Also in these times, GATE asked this type of question also. They give you the value of SST. They give you the value of V. They give you the value of F, they give you the value of TR, they ask you to find the gradient for up condition and for down condition. They give in question that a vehicle is moving on an up gradient and the design speed of a vehicle is 70 km per hour. The coefficient of friction is 0.38, because we know the coefficient of friction will vary from 0.35 to 0.4. So they use any value, they use 0.35, they use 0.36, 0.37, 0.38, 0.39, 0.4. And they give you the reaction time value. Also, they give you the stopping side distance value and ask from you calculate the gradient, and also calculate the down gradient, calculate the up gradient. So these are the questions framed by GATE during this recent time. So not much modification will be done from GATE side, because if you know the basic equations of your SST, and you, if you know all the aspects of your SST, technical aspects of an SST, that means analysis of your SST for lag distance, for braking distance, for flat road, for up gradient, for down gradient. If you know all these things, then you solve every question which is framed in any examinations. So is it clear to everyone? Is it clear to everyone? Okay.
Yes.
So I think these are the questions I want to discuss in class. So next discussion is on our taking side distance. Basically, our taking side distance I discuss in next class. So basically, the overtaking side distance is the minimum distance or visible to a driver to overtake the vehicle. So this is another type of side distance. So these things I discuss in your next class. Okay. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay.